Hello friends, you are watching ERUDIRE PLUS, the professional CAD-CAM solution provider. Let's get started.
Hello viewers, today I'm going to show you examples of CFD Flow Simulation through Free Surface Technique. It is like a puzzle. Interconnected containers are there. The containers are already filled up with air at the beginning itself, and from the top side you will provide water from the small opening, and we need to find out which container will be filled up first. That can be viewed from here. This is a free surface technique. So in this case, you are considering heterogeneous mixing of water and air. Already all the containers are filled up with air, and from top opening we will provide water. We know that as from the top side you are providing water at a specific rate, so definitely there should be some opening at any one of the different containers to close the flow simulation loop. That means if we are providing water from this top opening, definitely there should be some kind of opening to have an exit of this water or air particles. In this case, we have taken this is as entry of water and this one is the exit of water or air particles, right? Okay, so without wasting time, let us start our simulation. The model is already airtight because at these two openings we have provided leads. This is lead number one and this is lead two. Two different leads we have provided, and we need to start our flow simulation from here. And next to that, we need to initiate flow simulation environment from wizard itself, and we're keeping the name of the project as project 2. Next to that, we need to select unit system, and we're considering SI system, and temperature we can consider this one as degree Celsius, though in this case temperature is not an issue at all. Next to that, we need to select type of analysis. Definitely it is an internal analysis, and definitely it is not a steady state condition, because at different times you will get different results, so it will be transient analysis and we are depending on time, so it is time dependent. And in this case we are considering total analysis time to be 5 seconds, and output time steps we are considering as 1 second. It is after each 1 second we save the results, right? And gravity will be involved, and reaction gravity will be y, so along y it will be minus 9.81 meter per second square, and along z it will be 0. And definitely free surface will be included because it is a heterogeneous fluid mixing of water and air. Next to that, we need to select different fluids. Default fluids will be air, that will be at the beginning itself inside these different containers, and from outside we'll provide water. So another liquid is there, that will be water. We need to select both of them. So you can see here it is a immiscible mixture of water and air. So it is a free surface technique. It is a heterogeneous mixing of water and air. Next to that, this default wall thermal conditions and roughness are not having any effect in this case. So next to that, from thermodynamic parameters, pressure will be 10135 Pascal and temperature will be 20 degrees centigrade, though temperature is not an important criteria in this case. And concentration, initially it will be filled up with air. Let us finish this, right? You can see this is a computational domain, we can hide it. Next to that, we need to apply our boundary conditions. From top entry, we need to provide water at a specific rate. So boundary conditions, insert boundary conditions. It will be mass flow rate of water, or it can be inlet velocity of water also. And from substance concentration, we need to select what parameter is going in, right? So from substance concentration, we need to select water only. Instead of air, it will be water. So it is already filled up with air particles. And from top opening, we are providing water at a specific rate of 0.1 meter per second. Water we need to select from this face. So we can select it from here itself. Select other, it will be lead number one, selected, green check. So one boundary condition we have applied. Next boundary condition should be atmospheric pressure at the exit of this chamber, right? So another boundary condition to be applied here itself. Insert boundary condition, it will be atmospheric pressure at the exit location or environmental pressure at the exit location. select other. It is lead number 2. Grunt check. Both the boundary conditions are applied. In this case, we don't require to find out any kind of walls. Our aim is to view the dynamics of flow particles inside these different chambers. That is how the flow particles will be mixing. That means it will be mixing of water and air inside different chambers, and you can see which chamber will be filled up first. That can be viewed from this simulation, right? So we need to run this, and before running this simulation, we need to do something else. Like from solve, we need to select calculation control options, and from saving option, we need to select periodic, and from pressure, temperature, and different parameters, we need to select immiscible air, immiscible water, mass fraction of air and water. By the same time, we need to select volume fraction of water and air. Right? Okay. Done. Now we need to run this one. We have already run this one, and we can view the results from project one itself. Right? So for running, it will take some time. So to save the time, we'll see the results from project one with the same data. Let us see the results from project 1. Results are not loaded. We can load it. And also, first of all, we'll select the transient explorer. It is on. Now, insert cut plots. And we'll see volume fraction or mass fraction of water. Right? Mass fraction of water is selected. And you can select different things like mesh and also vectors and isolines. Let us select. So this is the distribution of your water and air inside different containers. Let us view it from the transient explorer. Let us run this. So you can see very clearly that this portion is actually filled up at the last moment. First portion, this first container is filled up first within a very short time. Then this one, this is never filled up. This one is very less, right? So we can analyze this one as at within a very short time. We can change the time duration also and see how it is changing, right? At different times, it is showing different results. At 3.8 seconds, this is the distribution of water and air mixing inside these different interconnected chambers. At 3.8 seconds, this is the position. And as time is changing, you can see the distribution is also changing. Right? We can do one thing. Next to that, we can see the surface plots also. That will provide a better idea, better view. It will be in a different representation. So this cut plots to clear and hide this one. And next to that, you want to see surface plots. Insert surface plots, and you want to see this mass fraction of water through all faces. Grunt check. This one is showing the 3D representation of these different chambers, interconnected chambers. We can see very clearly that first chamber is filled up first. That is volume fraction of or mass fraction of what is 100%. There is one, it is filled up completely. Second one, you can see, is not completely filled up. Third one, partially filled up, and fourth one is very less filled up. Right? You can see very clearly. Now we can do one thing. Excluding this surface plot, we can do something else. You can see something else like iso surfaces. That means it will be the interface between the water and air mixers. That can be also viewed from iso surfaces. Well, let us see this one from this transient explorer. This will be in the form of a solid. Actually, it is showing the boundaries or surfaces, right? It is a very good representation. Now, if you see the interface of water and air, that can be viewed from iso surfaces, right? Let us clear this one, and you're going to see isosurfaces. Insert isosurfaces, and value of this one is 0.5. Let us see. It will show the interface between the different heterogeneous mixtures of water and air. And 0.5 means it will be exactly the middle position of these two different mixtures, right? Let us see that from Transient Explorer. It will take some time for running this one. It is showing some kind of layer in between water and air. This water is in red color and air is in blue color. So the first chamber is filled up with water, 100%, it is in red color, right? So through this Transient Explorer, we can see the interface between water and air using isosurface. Let us stop it. We can animate this one through this option of animation, then that can be saved also. But we are not doing this one. Our aim was to see the dynamics of flow particles inside these different interconnected chambers. We wanted to see the heterogeneous mixing of water and air through different interconnected chambers, and you can see that the first chamber is filled up first, then the third one, then the second one, and finally the last one, right? Okay, let's see how we can go for animation. Insert animation, and in this animation it will show different results like cut plot 1, cut plot 2, surface plot 1, and isosurfaces. All these things will be shown in this animation, right? After animation, we can save it in the form of a video also, right? So with this one, we'll conclude our today's analysis. It is a very simple analysis of a free surface technique. In this analysis, we have shown different interconnected chambers were there, and through these interconnected chambers, we have provided water from top opening and seen that which chamber is filled up first, right? This was used using free surface technique, okay? Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. And if you have any kind of doubts, please write to me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye.